So this is an actual gray day that I painted on location. Yesterday in the painting tip 10 on my YouTube channel, I did the development of a gray day in Art Rage, a program that I'm using. So I'm just getting a simple drawing down, big shapes, and I'm using a Carb Othello pastel pencil. And if you look at the scene on the left, you can see that everything on the ground is darker than anything in the sky. So I'm going to be aware of that as I paint this. I'm just getting big shapes down now. And this is probably about a 45-minute painting on location. I do this every Monday for my students. So I'm just now going to start putting the color notes, one color note next to another. So I see some hills in the background, so I made them cooler so they go back, and now I'm putting in the big masses of trees there. Now, on a gray day, the colors are going to be closer to the local color. So those trees are kind of green, a cool green back there. On a sunny day, I might start with more of a lavender or purple or something. But on a gray day, everything is closer to the actual color, the local color. So I'm just, sometimes I try to redesign. There's my eye level, my horizon line. So I want to be aware of that. So I'm just putting in big shapes, not getting into detail yet. I can always do that as I develop the painting. So I'm going to do the lay-in today, and then I will post the development of that lay-in tomorrow. So these trees on the left were a little bit closer, so I made them a little bit warmer so they'd come in front of those right trees. This is a fence here, bringing you into the painting. Like I say, this is going to probably take me about 45 minutes to a half hour to cover the painting. And this is structure and form. I'm getting a good basis on which to then come in and reconsider and modify the colors and get them closer to what I see. And I'm trying to make this foreground, they do have a light and a shadow. So I'm putting in the shadow, and then I'm going to come in with the top planes there in light. These reeds in the foreground are very warm, so I've come in with a warmer color. So it comes forward. These are all things I'm thinking about when I'm painting. I'm trying not to repeat a color. Not to say that I can't have various oranges, but if once I use a certain color, I have to change either the temperature or the value in relationship to other colors. Okay, so now I'm getting into the sky and remembering that the sky is really lighter than anything on the ground. It's also cooler, although those light planes in the sky are going to be pretty warm. I'm going to probably come in with a yellow. So I'm just quickly putting in these big masses, and then I always can reconsider and change them as I develop this painting further. So here's the light planes, or the light coming through the clouds there. And I'm using a warm, which at some point I'm going to cool down. So I'm getting a basic structure on which to work with, and then I can come in and modify it, change it, think about the shapes. But I quickly cover the canvas. Until I have all the colors down, can I start?